Hey everyone, this is Vignesh from VNMU. Today we are going to see about anatomy of the lungs. So today we'll see the structures present in the lungs. What is meant by bronchopulmonary segment? What is bronchial tree? Artery and veins which present in the lungs and nerve supply to the lungs. So lungs, which exactly located in the thoracic cavity, either side of a mediastinum, which present in the rib cage, under the rib cage. So we have a right lung and the left lung. So first of all, we'll see what are the structures which present in the lungs. So here we have a bronchus and a trachea. So we have a right lung and left lung. So what are the structures which present in the lungs? In a lung, the area which the starting point of a lungs, which is called apex, which is exactly located according to the thoracic level, according to the rib cage. The apex, which is exactly located in the first rib, and then it near to the floor of neck. So the point which the lungs arises, the area is called apex. And then we have a base. So in the base we have a muscle called diaphragma. So this is diaphragma. This place is called a base. So this place is called base of the lungs. So the lungs, which is divided into lobes. So these lobes are separated by a fissures. So for example, in the right side, the lungs is divided into three lobes. So the right lungs, which is divided into three lobes. The left lung, which is divided into two lobes. So we have superior lobe, middle lobe and inferior lobe. In the left lung, we have superior lobe and inferior lobe. So the superior lobe and middle lobe, which is separated by this fissure, which is like a septum, which separate the lungs. This fissure is called horizontal fissure. So superior lobe and the middle lobe, which is separated by horizontal fissure, and the middle lobe and inferior lobe, which is separated by oblique fissure, because it's separating the lobe in a oblique manner. So in the left lung, we have a superior lobe and inferior lobe. First of all, I will write the lobes. So this is superior lobe, this is middle lobe, and this is inferior lobe. So in the left lung, we have superior lobe and then inferior lobe. The superior lobe and the inferior lobe, which is separated by a oblique fissure. So it's going in an oblique manner. And also, when we compare to the lungs shape and structure, the left lung, which is a little bit different when compared to the right lung, because of the place in the mediastinum, in the compartment, in the mediastinal compartment, we have a heart which present in between the two lungs. There is a presence of heart. So this heart will create a cardiac impression to the left lung. The place I have drawn here in a C shaped, which is a cardiac impression, which is a cardiac notch, which is called as a cardiac notch. In some book, they described this cardiac notch, this cardiac impression as lingula. For a left lung, they told middle lobe, there is a presence of middle lobe, it is called as a lingula. So, I'm writing here, lingula. In some book, they told in a left lung, we have only two lobes, one in superior lobe and inferior lobe. So, in some book, they described as in the left lung, we also have a middle lobe. That is called as lingula. That place is called cardiac notch or a cardiac impression. So, and then we have a surfaces. So, when I turn this lungs, where the bronchus enters into the place. So, in this place, we have a bronchus. Which entering to the lungs. This place is called as a mediastinal surface. The place where presence of root of lungs or ileum of lungs or radix of lungs, root or ileum or radix of lungs. The place where bronchus enter into the lungs, the place is called as a mediastinal surface. Mediastinal surface. The place where attach or connect with the ribcage, that place is called as costal surface. So, and then under we have a diaphragma, the muscle for which is used for inspiration. So, this place is called diaphragmatic surface. Diaphragmatic surface. So, the place where the bronchus enter into the lungs, which is called as a mediastinal surface, the place which are related to the ribcage, which is a costal surface, the place where related to the diaphragma, which is a diaphragmatic surface. So, we have a three surfaces and we have a three borders. So, we have anterior border, inferior border and posterior border. So, borders. So, the anterior borders, the communication between mediastinal surface and the costal surface. When you compare to the right lung, the anterior borders is the communication between mediastinal surface and the costal surface. When you compare in the left lung, the communication between mediastinal surface and the apex of the cardiac notch of the heart, the lingula. Anterior border, which is a kind of connection between mediastinal surface and the costal surface. When in the left lung, the mediastinal surface and the cardiac notch or cardiac impression. The inferior border, which separates the mediastinal surface and the costal surface. The posterior border, the connection between mediastinal surface and the costal surface in posterior manner. So we have three borders, anterior borders, so connection between mediastinal surface and costal surface, the left lung, mediastinal surface and the lingula, the inferior border which is separate mediastinal surface and the costal surface, the posterior border, the connection of mediastinal surface and the costal surface in the posterior manner. So these are the contents which present in the lungs, these are the structures which present in the lungs. So we have apex, we have base and we have lobes. In the right lung, we have a three lobe. The left lung, we have two lobe. So these lobes are separated by fissures. It's like a septum which separate the lungs into lobes. So in the right lung, we have horizontal fissure, oblique fissure. In the left lung, we have oblique fissure which separates superior lobe and inferior lobe. So in the left lung, we also described lingula, then a place where cardiac impression, the cardiac notch is present. And then we have three surfaces. One is a mediastinal surface, one is a costal surface, one is diaphragmatic surface. And we have three borders. One is anterior border, inferior border, and posterior border. So these are the contents or structures which are present in the lungs. So now we'll see what is meant by bronchopulmonary segment. So we already saw we have three lobes in the three lobes in a right lung and two lobes in a left lung. So in this lobe there is a presence of segments. So in the right lung, they told we have 10, sometimes 12 segments. So this lobe in then separated into segments, 10 segments. In some book they told we have 12 segments. So in a left lung they told 8 or sometimes 9 segments. So I'm not going to tell the segments names. If you want, I have given you in the description box, so go and see. So in the right lung we have 10 or 12 segments, in the left lung 8 or 9 segments. So this segment is called as a bronchopulmonary segment. So we can say this bronchopulmonary segment is then divided into 10 segment and 8 segment. So the lobe which is divided into segments, that is called as bronchopulmonary segments. So now we'll see bronchial tree. So what is bronchial tree? So the formation of bronchial tree starts from larynx and then go to trachea. The trachea and then go to bronchus. The bronchus, we have right bronchus and left bronchus. And then this bronchus, which is divided into lobular, bronchi, and then which is then divided into segmental bronchi. So this segmental bronchi which supply air to bronchopulmonary segments. You already saw what is meant by bronchopulmonary segment. This bronchopulmonary segment is called as a functional unit of lungs. So this is an important thing to know about the bronchus, the bronchial tree, functional unit of lungs. Maybe your teacher can ask this question: what is the functional unit of lungs? Which is a bronchopulmonary segment. Bronchopulmonary segment is called as a functional unit of lungs. This segmental bronchi, which is then divided into terminal bronchi. This terminal bronchi has hair-like hair like hair filling like sacs, which have sacs like structure, that is called as alveoli. Finally, it's hind ear. So the bronchial tree, which is starting from larynx and then it connected to trachea, and then the bronchus, we have a left bronchus and right bronchus, which is divided and it go to the right lung and left lung, and then which is divided into, when it enter into the lung, which is then divided into lobular bronchi, segmental bronchi and terminal bronchi. This segmental bronchi, which give air to the bronchopulmonary segment, which is called as a functional unit of lungs. And then the segmental bronchi, which is divided into terminal bronchi. In the terminal bronchi, we have, there is a structure like sacs, which is called as a alveoli. So now we'll see what is called as a root or a helium or a radix of a lungs. In the lungs root, we have a difference in the right lung and left lung. So first of all, we'll take a left lung. In a left lung, when you see the end of bronchus to the lung. So this is a right lung. So first of all, we'll see the bronchus, and then we have pulmonary artery, and we have a two veins, we have two pulmonary veins. Under the pulmonary veins, we have bronchial vessels, and then we have nose, and then we have lymphatic vessels. So for confirmation, I have written like this, but it will look like in a simple manner. For a confirmation, I have written like this. So first of all, in a tube, there is a presence of bronchus, pulmonary artery, one pulmonary artery, two pulmonary veins for one lung, and then we have bronchial vessels. In the bronchial vessel, there is a presence of a bronchial artery and bronchial veins, and then nerve supply and lymphatic vessel, there is a presence of a lymphs. So in the left lung, first there will be a pulmonary artery, after that it will be bronchus, and then you will note out pulmonary vein. After the pulmonary vein, there is a bronchial vessels, and will be a nerve supply, and then lymphatic vessels. So there is a difference of the bronchial interchange in the lungs. So this is the left lung. So the right lung and left lung, there is a change between bronchus and the pulmonary artery. So and then you can also note out the difference in the bronchus after trachea, which is divided into bronchus. In the left lung, the bronchus, it will be like this. So in a child, the bronchus will be in a same manner, but in adult it will have some difference, like 45 degrees, like it has some difference. The entering to the lungs, it has some difference in the bronchus. You can also, the bifurcation of bronchus have a difference between right lung and left lung. Also, the entering of the root of lungs, the helium of the lungs, also have a difference between bronchus and pulmonary artery. So now we'll see what are the veins and nerves which present in the lungs. When I take out the line, when I take out the alveoli, you can see the pulmonary vein, and I can see the pulmonary artery, and then I can see the alveolar duct. So when I take the alveoli, I can see the pulmonary vein, pulmonary artery, and then alveolar duct. And also in the lung, we can see the bronchial artery, which is the branch of descending aorta, and then we have bronchial vein. We have a left and right bronchial vein. This right bronchial vein, which is drained into esophagus vein, and then this left bronchial vein, which is drained into hemiesophagus vein. So in alveoli, we can see the pulmonary vein, pulmonary artery, and alveolar duct. In the lungs, we'll observe a bronchial artery, which is a branch of a descending aorta, and then bronchial vein, we have left and right bronchial vein, the right bronchial vein, which is drained into aorta's vein, and the left bronchial vein, which is drained into hemiaorta's vein. So now we'll see the nerve supply. So nerve supply mainly by pulmonary plexus. The nerve supply mainly by pulmonary plexus. This pulmonary plexus have a sympathetic nerves, parasympathetic nerves, and then there is a presence of visceral afferent fibers. There is a presence of visceral afferent fibers. So this pulmonary plexus have sympathetic nerves, parasympathetic nerves, and visceral afferent fibers. This sympathetic nerves, which arises from sympathetic trunk, which is used for vasoconstriction of pulmonary vessels, and then relaxation of bronchial smooth muscle. So this parasympathetic, which arises from vagus nerve, which is used for vasodilation of bronchial vessels, and then constriction of bronchial smooth muscles, and then secretion of bronchial glands. So for a mucus production, and then this afferent, visceral afferent fibers, which conduct pain impulses to the vagus nerve. So the nerve supply, which is mainly by pulmonary plexus. The pulmonary plexus, there is a presence of sympathetic fibers, parasympathetic fibers, visceral afferent fibers. Sympathetic fibers, which arises from sympathetic trunk, which used for vasoconstriction of pulmonary vessels, relaxation of a bronchial smooth muscle. This parasympathetic nerves, which arises from vagus nerve, which is used for vasodilation of a pulmonary vessels, constriction of a bronchial smooth muscle, secretion of a bronchial glands for a mucus secretion, and then visceral afferent fibers, which conduct pain impulses to the vagus nerve. So the lungs, which is covered by pleura, we have a visceral pleura and parietal pleura. In between a pleura, there is a serous fluid, which is used for a shock absorption, which is used for shock absorption during inspiration and expiration. So mainly lungs is used for respiration functions, and also it involved in some metabolisms like renin, angiotensin, aldosterone systems. So it also involved in another mechanisms to maintain to our body. So now we'll see the clinical aspects which are related to the lungs. So mainly we connected with the environment by the lungs through inspiration and expiration. So mainly we'll get infections, and then some of the pathologies which are related to the pleura, which is called as pleurisy. And then we have a pneumonia due to infections, and then we have so many pathologies which are related to the lungs. And then we have some of the problems with inspiration and expirations. So we have so many pathologies which are related to the lungs. So we'll try to discuss this infectious disease which are related to the lungs, and then some of the inspiration and expiration problems, some of the mechanical problems which are related to the lungs. We'll discuss it later in another video. So this is all about lungs, the anatomy of the lungs. So thanks for watching. We'll continue to some other topics and some other videos. Thanks. So I have given you the what is the segments for a bronchopulmonary segment. I have given you the segments which present in the lobes. So thanks for watching. Thanks.